Hello everyone, it's Vicky, and I'm here today to do a review of some notebooks. Now, the company reached out to me and asked if I'd be willing to, and I said yes because I've actually had my eye on these. I literally had them in my cart, and it was so weird. It's almost like they got notified that I had them in my cart. So, the notebooks I'm talking about are called Dingbats, and if you're looking on Amazon for A5 notebooks, you'll most likely run into them. Now, this notebook that I have here is a Leuchtturm A5 that I do a lot of project and note writing, as well as like ideas for YouTube and my Etsy shops. It's housed in a Chic Sparrow kind of folio cover, or Hobonichi cover. I don't believe Jennifer Macy's anymore. I wish she did because it's a really cool cover. But I wanted to bring this out because it's very reminiscent to me of the Leuchtturm. And we're going to test it out. We're going to check out the papers and see what they all have to offer. I'll have it linked down below. But like I said, I saw this on Amazon and was really intrigued by them. I love a bound notebook, especially for like note writing, journal keeping. I mean, geez, I don't think I've met a notebook really that I didn't love or couldn't find a reason to love. So this here is a A5. It's got 192 pages, 96 sheets, plain and perforated, 100 GSM cream paper, which is like my jam. I believe they have cream and white paper. I'll have everything linked down below, but I believe they have cream and white. Got a little scuffed up and dinged up here. This is really cool. I believe this is PU leather, but it's made to feel super cool, like pebbly leather is really what it feels like. Doesn't have any weird smells. It's got some cool animals on there. I've seen some really neat prints that are on there. For my bullet journal folks, I think they'll really dig these notebooks. I love the size of them. Really great size. And I'm trying to see, but it looks like these sheets up close are perforated, which is pretty cool to have perforated sheets. What is the perk of having a perforated sheet? Well, if you made an error, obviously you can just tear it out. I know there's a lot of type A folks in the bullet journaling community, as well as in the planning community, and as well as any other community. And so if you were uncomfortable with a page, you can always tear it out. Or if you wrote a note to someone, you could pop it out. I do like the chunkiness of this. I like that 96 sheets. Really love that very much. I believe the Leuchtturm probably has just about that much as well. So yeah, love it. Love the size. I really like this like PU leather though. It feels really cool. I'm sad that it got a little dinged up, but that's okay. That's not, you know, anyone's fault. That is, would be my daughter screaming in the background. So here's a look on the inside here. And then here's our beautiful plain cream paper. I love that. We've got a little bookmark in here. Got a pen loop, which is really nice. You don't get that with Leuchtturm. You do have to purchase that with Leuchtturm. You get a little back pocket here, which is nice. Kind of reminds me of moleskin. And then here's all the cool designs that they have for their different collections. So this is the wildlife collection, it looks like. And let's see, they have notebooks that kind of are like the reporter style, so they flip up if that's something you prefer. And they also have a pocket one right here as well. Really cool, just really, really like it. So let's see, I guess this is a little just like kind of back story on it. Just says, my great grandfather established one of the first paper shops in Lebanon in the early 19th century, trading high quality paper more or less continuously from then until the present day. And I passionately believe that there's still a place for this most traditional of materials in today's high speed digital world. Absolutely, there is, for sure. I love analog, and these are pretty gosh darn cool. I like how these feel. Love the size of these too. So we're going to test out the paper. I'm going to show you the other notebook as well. But I like this a lot. I mean, this is so nice. It's pretty lay flat. You can see it's pretty lay flat. You do have to work the pages a little bit, but you do have most notebooks. You know, they do have the option of grid, or the next one I'm going to show you is graph. But I love this. I like the size of this. Really nice. So I'm going to take out some pens. We're going to test the paper out in the back here. Yeah, I really like this. This is like a green color, which I love. It's got the elastic closure there to keep it nice and contained, which I really love. This is a really nice journal. So for my Bujo folks that are out there, that's a really nice option for you if you're wanting to venture outside of the Leuchtturm notebooks. We'll test out the paper. The only thing I'm going to say comparing right off the bat with the Leuchtturm is that it doesn't have that table of contents or the pages numbered. Not that that's a deal breaker. It's just that I know that some people kind of focus on on that, but these are so cool. Like, this PU leather feels awesome. It's just such a cool pebbly feel. I love how this feels. Oh my gosh, look at this grid. This is so cool. This has a little bear paw prints in here. Did this one have bear paw prints? I didn't even notice. Let me check. No, cool. This one has deer hooves. How cute is that? Because it's a deer. It's got little deer hooves in there. And this one's got little bear paws. I love this grid. This is so cool. So this grid, this paper feels really cool too. It feels really nice. Very nice. I like the round corners on there. There's a lecture. Yeah, they have that too. Really like how this paper feels though. I'm going to have a pretty good feeling that this paper is going to be pretty decent because it feels really nice. I like this grid a lot. It is not super faint, so I'm going to show you, like, the dots in the Leuchtturm. It are pretty faint, and then you can also compare the cream color in their cream version versus the Leuchtturm. Leuchtturm is definitely more yellow, more of that, like, Clairefontaine. This one's not quite as yellow. I still love it. It's not that super stark white, which I don't love that. I believe they offer it in the stark white. I don't love stark white. I think I have stark white paper here just to show you. These are my little stickers in my Etsy shop. I think just to show, I'm trying to get more white in here. So here's some white. You can see it's not super stark white, but it's not that super yellow like you find in the Leuchtturm. But oh, I love this grid. I love this size for some reason. It feels like it's a different size from the Leuchtturm, but these pages are really nice. I'm assuming this is sewn. It's really hard to see. But I don't believe this is glue bound. It does not look glue bound. It's glue and sewn. So there are, yep. So it's really nice. Very nice binding. Really nicely put together. I gotta say, like, just really nicely put together. I like these a lot. Very affordable price point, I believe. I'll have them linked down below so you guys can check them out. And they're easy to get on Amazon. But I really am digging this. The feel, the texture, I really like that a lot. It just feels really cool. I feel like for my Bujo friends is really nice. So here I got that Leuchtturm, and it's again in that Chic Sparrow cover. I really use a lot of pages in here just for, you can see I've got like tabs in here. This is like something where I like to write like a lot of my ideas, like I mentioned, for Etsy classes, for just big ideas, things I need to work out, lots of mind mapping, that kind of a thing. That's how I like to use these notebooks. That's just my, you know, what I like to do personally. So, couple things to mention. Again, I think a lot of people are familiar with Leuchtturm, and these were very reminiscent to me of the Leuchtturm. That's why the only reason I'm doing a comparison is so that people get kind of a good idea. So, one of the things right off the bat, you don't get the page numbers. It's not a deal breaker for me. I've done the bullet journal for a while. I've been on and off with it, and I don't mind numbering my pages. It's not that big of a deal. I also don't like having the table of contents in the front. I actually prefer having an index in the back. So for me, that's not a deal breaker because I prefer going in the back here and creating my own index and going off of that rather than having the table of contents in the front. But, you know, that's what Leuchtturm has, which is cool. I like it. You know, I like that they have that there for you, but I don't know. I like to, because, like, what if you run out of space? You know, if you do it in the back, but you can always do it in the front and back. It's up to you. I mean, it's just, you know, it's going to be your personal preference. The Leuchtturm comes with two bookmarks. This one has one bookmark. But I just, I don't know. I really like the paper in this. It's really cool. We're going to definitely have to pen test this just to see what's going on here. I do like that they've added that little pen loop in there. Leuchtturm, like I said, you have to buy the pen loop in order to have that, but very cool, man. I really like this. I like how this feels. So let's do some pen testing. Let's play around with these. I do really like these journals. I saw my husband eyeballing them too, trying to steal them from me. He's like, don't you have enough journals? No. Does he know who he married? I mean, I can't believe you asked me that question. Let me grab some pens and we'll test out this paper. All right, my daughter's watching Pokemon, so they might get a little out of hand here in just a minute. So I'm going to go in the back of the grid here because it's easier for me to show you on the lines what's going on. So I'm going to go in the back. What I pulled was some pens and markers that are somewhat common, but maybe not totally, in case you wanted to use this as like a sketchbook, a journal, that kind of a thing. You may not use like your traditional Bic pen or whatever, but I have a vanishing point. This isn't an extra fine, so it doesn't have quite as much ink pouring out of it, but I use this all the time in my planner because I love that click feature. I also have the Platinum Cool, and this is a really awesome pen. It's got the G Urban ink in here, and it has gold flex in there, which is so awesome. You can see the gold kind of sitting in the barrel. This one is a little more wet, but I love, oh, this writes so nicely on this paper. I don't even want to stop. Wow, this is so nice on this paper. Holy cow. It's almost, it almost feels like Rhodia paper a little bit, like that real buttery kind of a feel. I also have a Pilot G2, which is, I think, a very popular pen, easy to get your hands on. I'm choosing red because I think it's a pretty easy color to see. I also threw a mild liner in here. I got two colors of mild liners. I feel like mild liners are ones that are kind of culprits and tend to bleed through a lot, which is unfortunate because I really like their colors. So I have a pink one and then I have a yellow one, just to kind of see how that works on this paper. I also have a fine liner here. These remind me of the Le Pen as well as the Stabilos, but I got these at Staples, so they're Staples brand. And then I have just a regular Bic pen. This writes nice and smooth, but really, when you're writing with a fountain pen in this, you're really going to feel the pleasure of writing in this notebook. There's something about a really nice pen and paper. When that connection happens, it's amazing. This is a Pilot calligraphy, like marker almost. Is a very, very wet pen. Then I have my Pentel Energel. I love how this writes. It writes super smooth on here. It's got a needle tip on there. You can find that at Walmart, Target, all those places. And then I also incorporated some Copics. I've seen a couple people drawing with Copics in their Leuchtturms. I know it's the sketchbook, but let's just see what happens with a Copic. Usually it bleeds through. I know, because it's alcohol based, but I'm just curious how badly. So I got a light one and a darker one. I will give it a few seconds to kind of dry, make its magic. The reason for that is a lot of times paper absorbs things and it takes a couple seconds for that to happen. Not all paper works like that Tomoe River paper. That Tomoe River paper tends to have that ink like sit on top, so the ink has to actually like dry, and it needs some dry time in order to do that. But we'll give it a second and see here what happens. And wow, look at that. That's pretty gosh darn impressive, you guys. Even the light Copic didn't even really bleed that badly. That like pistachio one. Only the red, which, you know, I'm not that shocked, but this lighter one, not so bad. The calligraphy, this, I mean, that is such a wet ink that I'm not surprised that it ghosted through like crazy. But a lot of these others, really, there's minimal shadowing. So the fountain pen up here, I think that's what is the fountain pen here, the Platinum Cool one. There's some shadowing up here, but it's kind of shadowing like Tomoe River paper. So it's not like annoying. You don't see it too much. The vanishing point, you don't see anything. The mild liner, the pink one, you see a little bit of shadowing, a little ghosting. Other than that, though, this did pretty gosh darn well with the pen test. I'm really impressed. It's a very smooth paper to write on. Super duper smooth to write on. And the Leuchtturm, let me see really quick. I just am curious how that Platinum Cool feels writing on this paper, just out of curiosity. I want to see if it's as smooth. It's not. It's got a little more grit to it when I write with the fountain pen. This has that feel of like Rhodia paper. Yeah. It has Rhodia paper, if you are a fountain pen user, is a must. They are they were made for each other, honestly. They are just such a beautiful like union, a beautiful marriage together. And I'd say this is pretty close. It has that same kind of buttery texture with that fountain pen. This has more, a little bit more of a grit. Even when you run your hands over the paper, this has a little more like tooth to it. This has a real slippery, almost like sheen, like a You know, if I was skiing on this paper, I'd be going. If I was, I'd be catching a little on this one. But I do love Leuchtturm. I don't want to, like, hassle them too much. You do get a little more paper, it looks like, in the Leuchtturm. You get 249, you got 196 in here. But I really like these Dingbats. I mean, I really, really like these. Definitely will get a lot of use by me because I do a lot of note-taking, note-writing, and I love these this style of notebooks. Love them. So that's my cue to go since Hank is barking. I hope you guys enjoyed this review and you do check out the Dingbats. These are really cool. I love this green color. It's beautiful, especially with the deer. I love it. They're super affordable. I'll have them linked down below. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you guys again. Take care. Bye-bye.